Hello everyone, now we are going to be discussing next non-linear, non-primitive data structure, that is arrays. In previous class we discussed list, in which we are going to be discussed linear data structure, the operation performed on linear data structure. Now we are going to be discussing one more non-primitive data structure, that is arrays. In previous year we discussed this array chapter. Once again, I am going to be defining definition of array, how to define array, and types of array. What do you mean by array? Array is a collection of homogeneous data elements. Means if you want to store a single kind of data items, these are only possible with help of, by declaring as an array, it can store into these structures. These are able to allow to collect only similar kind of data items. Those are called as an array. Then how to define array? To define array, we are having syntax. There is data type array name in square bracket size, then with semicolon. It is nothing but we need to declare any data type that is integer a of 10. Means where a is an array type data structure which is able to store 10 different elements into that. That is how we are going to be declaring array data structure. It is a simple collection of homogeneous data elements. Now arrays are classified into three different types. Those are one dimensional array, two dimensional array, and multi dimensional array. These arrays are classified based on, we are going to identify these arrays based on subscript of that array, means how many elements we are allowed to store in a row wise, column wise. Based on that, we are going to be classified into three different types. First one is one dimensional array. One dimensional arrays are those which are having only one subscript, means these are allowed to store elements of into that data structure either in the form of row or column. Such arrays are called as an one dimensional array. For example, integer x of 5. This is a subscript. It is a subscript which is able to store 5 elements either in the form of rows or of columns. Such type of arrays are called as a one dimensional array. The next one is two dimensional array. Two dimensional arrays are those which are having two subscripts, means the form of rows and columns. Those are called as a two dimensional array. Example, integer x 3,3 means two x data structure. X is an array which is able to store 3 into 3 total 9 elements in the form of 3 rows and 3 columns. Such type of arrays are called as a two dimensional array. The next one is multi dimensional array. Multi dimensional arrays are those in which there are more than two subscripts are existing. Such type of arrays are called as a multi dimensional array. Means we are able to work called as a multi dimensional array. Now we need to discuss how to find length of an array. To find length of an array, it can be calculated using the help of formula called as length equal to upper bound minus lower bound plus 1, which gives the total length of array. Total length of array is nothing but how many number of elements we are allowed to store into that respective array can be identified by using this formula. Let us consider an array. In this array, which is upper bound, which is lower bound? The lowest index of an array is called as a lower bound, and the highest index of an array is called as an upper bound. Once again, In a given array, the lowest index of an array is called as a lower bound, and the highest index of an array is called as an upper bound. Now we know lower bound and upper bound. Now we need to calculate the total elements, how many elements we can store into this array by using this formula. What is upper bound? Upper bound is 6 minus lower bound is 0 plus 1 plus 1 is equal to 6 plus 1 7. Means the length of this array is 7. Length of this array 7 means we are allowed to store 7 elements into this array. We are allowed to store 7 elements into this array. Those are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7 elements I store in this array. It is called as a total length of array. It is simply identified by the declaring an array. Integer x of 7. Integer x of 7. Where 7 describes how many elements we are allowed to store in that respective array. It is called as a length. It can be calculated with a formula for length equal to upper bound minus lower bound plus 1. I think you got about how to calculate length of an array. Okay, friends. Now we need to discuss operation performed on array. In previous video lecture, we discussed about operation performed on non-primitive data structure. The same operations which we are performing on arrays also. Those are traversal, insertion, deletion, searching, sorting, merging. It is the important questions. This question might be asked for 3 marks as well as 5 marks. The same operations we are also performing on array. Now we are going to discuss in detail about what do you mean by these operations and how we are performing on array. The first one is traversal. Traversal is an operation which is going to be visiting each node of a given data structure exactly once for performing certain operations. Let us consider this array integer A of 6, in which I stored 6 different elements. Those are 10, 20, 15, 25, 30, 40. I stored 6 different elements in this array. If I perform traversal operation, traversal operation means which is going to be visiting each node of a given data structure exactly once for performing certain operations. Means if you want to access certain elements and if you want to perform addition, subtraction, multiplication or division, if you are performing any operation, operation might be anything, either searching, sorting, sometimes searching, sorting also. But visiting each node of this given data structure for a certain operation is called as a traversing, which is nothing but I am going to be visiting each and every node for performing certain operations, which is not possible to directly access. If you know the index of that array, we are directly access that element. If you don't know the position of that element, then we have to visit each and every node. That is called as a traversal operation. Traversal means visiting each node of a given data structure exactly once for a certain operation. Operation might be anything. It might be a searching, sorting or any algebraic operations. Next one is insertion operation. Insertion is an operation which is going to be inserting new data element into given structure. Now I am adding 6 elements into this data structure. I want to add one more data element into this structure, which is possible with help of insertion operation, which is going to be inserting new data element into this structure. Next one is deletion operation. Deletion is an operation which is going to be removing an existing element from given data structure. Now I am adding 5 elements. If you remove any one of these existing elements, it is called as a deletion operation. Deletion is an operation which is going to be removing existing element from the given data structure. It is called as a deletion operation. The element must be existing. It is not possible to delete an element which does not exist in this array. Let us consider we are having these elements 10, 20, 15, 25, 30, 40. Now you try to delete an element 5. You try to delete an element 5 which does not exist in this array, then it is not called as a deletion operation. Deletion is only possible that element must be exist in a given data structure. That is called as a deletion operation. Next one is searching. Searching is an operation which is going to be finding or locating of a particular element in a given array. Now I want to search element 15. it is located in this element, or finding the location of that element which is located in this given data structure is called as a searching operation. Means element 15 is located at position 2 or located at index 2 is called as a searching operation. Next one is sorting operation. Sorting operation, sorting is a technique which is going to be reorganizing the elements of a given data structure in particular order. Order is either ascending or descending, is called as sorting. Let us consider I have certain elements into this array. Now I want to organize these elements into ascending order. Means 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 40. Is called as a sorting operations. Means I organize, reorganize element of this data structure into particular order. That order is ascending. It is also possible to organize these elements in descending order also. That is called as a sorting operation. Next one is merging operation. Merging is an operation which will be combining two or more data structure to form a single data structure. That is considered. Now I am going to define two different array and I want to combine those two array into single array. Okay, see this example. Now I have two different arrays, those are integer A of 3, I store 3 elements, those are 1, 3, 5. Now I declare one more array, that is integer of B, size 3, which is in which also I store 3 elements. Now A and B are two different arrays. Now if I am going to perform merging operations on these two different arrays, it is going to be combining these two different array to form a single array, is called as a merging operations. Merging is an operation which is going to be combining two or more arrays to form a single array. If I perform merging operations on these two arrays, it is going to be combining the elements of these two arrays and form a single array, which is like this: 1, 3, 5, 2, 4, 6. Now I perform the merging operations on these two arrays. Simple merging is an operation which is going to be combining two or more arrays to form a single array. These completes operation performed on arrays.